paving products training team. Today we're going to talk about the maintenance intervals on the AP 1055F asphalt paver. This will only cover the asphalt paver. It does not include the screed. Okay, for a 10-hour check, we always want to make sure that we check our engine oil. Alright, first thing in the morning or first thing before your shift, come out and check your engine oil, pull the dipstick out, wipe it down, put it back in, make sure it seats all the way. Then pull it back out and check your oil. Oil level's good, put it back in. If you need to add engine oil to the engine oil fill is right here. While you're in this area checking your engine oil, you also check your transmission oil. Transmission oil dipstick is located right here. It's the purple one. So we pull that one all the way up. All right. Again, wiping it down. And we put it back in. Now, make sure this one seats all the way down and it snaps in. All right, then pull it out and check your oil level. Okay. Now, when you check the oil level on the transmission, the engine must be running. If you have to put transmission oil in the machine, transmission oil fill is right here. Continuing on with the 10-hour checks, we're going to check the hydraulic oil now. So you need to lift the left-hand panel and then lift the right-hand panel, secure the panel. All right, dipstick is right on top of the hydraulic tank. So we'll pull the dipstick out, we'll wipe it off, then we'll reinstall the dipstick, make sure it seats. Pull the dipstick and make sure that the hydraulic oil is always between the full and the add marks. Reinstall the dipstick. Okay, at that point, go ahead and check everything else around your hydraulic tank, right? Fuel tank, everything in this area. Check for leaks, check for loose bolts. Continuing with the 10-hour check, while the machine is cold, do a coolant level check. Right, your coolant shunt tank is located on the center console under a cover here. Then you have an access port where you can see the add and the fill lines. Right, make sure that the coolant is maintained between the add and the fill marks. Right, if you have to add coolant to the machine, make sure the machine is cold. Remove the lid here and add the ELC in there before you put your cap back on. Make sure that the O-ring is good and seated inside the cap. All right, then secure the cap. Make sure it's good and tight. Also on the 10-hour check, you need to check your backup alarm. So turn the ignition switch on the machine. All right, then go to your console that's activated. You see your console's activated up here. Take the propel lever and just move the propel lever to the reverse position. Once you can hear your backup alarm, then you can return it to neutral, and that's the full check. All right, the next on our 10-hour list is inspect your seat belt. Always make sure your seat belt is in good shape. All right, go in and check the webbing on the seat belt. Check all of the hardware on the seat belt, right, on both sides, on the buckle, right, and on the insertion piece. All right, then pull the belt all the way out, and you should have an inspection label on the belt, right? On this particular belt, it has July 19, 2019 on it. Okay, up here, it's got an install by date of 2023, right? So the date of the manufacture of this machine is the date the seat belt was installed. So 3 years from the date it was installed, that seat belt is good. Anything after 3 years, seat belt should be replaced. All right, also on your 10-hour checks, you want to come over and check your water separator. All right, on your primary fuel filter. So down here is the water separator. Here's the drain for the water separator. So get a suitable container, open the drain up, allow the water to drain out, all right, and then close it back up and dispose of whatever you've drained out of here properly. On a 10-hour inspection, we're going to inspect the undercarriage. So what you want to do is you want to make sure that you have no leaks, all your bolts are tightened, check the rubber around all of your idler wheels, your front idler, your mid rollers. Make sure all your bolts are good and tight. Your retaining pin right here, make sure that's good and tight, and then just follow it all back, looking for oil leaks at each one of your rollers. Remember, you do have an internal and an external roller, so inspect all aspects of it. Okay, just follow it all the way back, always checking your retaining pins. Alright, check your bolts, make sure everything is tight. Go back to your drive wheel, look at all the rubber on the drive wheel, make sure it's in place. And look at your track as you're going along to make sure that that track is not gouged or ripped. Alright, just make sure it's in good shape. Still on the 10-hour checks, this is the ventilation ducting. We always want to make sure that we inspect this and keep it clean. You've got one above each of your drag chains. So make sure you go in here and clean these out on a daily basis. Remember, always refer to the operation and maintenance manual for the proper procedures when doing your hourly checks.